Schultz taking on the one and only Dominic DiNucci.
Well, is that all you got to say about an old man, Dominic DiNucci? I got a lot I can say about you, old man. One thing, I think you're stepping a little high for your age. Another thing, I don't think you've been reading the newspapers. I don't think you've been reading the magazines. I don't think you've been watching TV. I don't think you've been keeping up with Dr. D and the people he's been stomping on, the people he's been walking over. I don't think you knew exactly who you were signing to meet tonight. Well, you're signing to meet the world's greatest wrestler of all time, the Fred. No man that walked in the face of the earth. You signed to meet me, baby, the one and only, the only man that has ever been denied matches all over the world, been kicked out of 7 different countries. And now you're climbing in the ring with me. Well, let me tell you something, old man. Take your heart pills. Get your heart to pumping good. Eat all you can eat, all this health food that I know you people have to eat, prunes and stuff like that. You eat them. Don't be laughing at what I'm saying about this old man, because you're going to be old just like him real soon. And you might get old a lot quicker out here laughing with me. You hear what I'm saying? Now, Dominic DiNucci, say your prayers. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy all your old films you got. Sit home and watch them. Sit home and watch them and live the glorified years that you used to live in professional wrestling, because it's about to come to an end. Because I'm going to wrap these mamas right here around that old skinny neck of yours, and I'm going to make you get on your knees, and I'm going to make you say, Dr. D, please don't hit me no more.
June 22nd at theaters everywhere.
Welcome back to Championship Wrestling. Fans, just before the break, I talked to you about a man who pushed the heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Zbyszko, to a television time limit draw. Indeed, the trooper, the long left arm of the law, had the big pinch on the heavyweight champ. But as I mentioned, time ran out. The trooper came within a heartbeat of winning the most coveted title in professional sports, the AWA World Heavyweight Championship.
Remember, submission, no good. Throwing him out, no good. He needs to pin him. The trooper needs to pin him for the belt.
And as you can see, the covering is off the ring corner. Larry actually took the cover off, and it worked to his disadvantage. Oh, right into the breadbasket. And if Zbyszko didn't have the wind knocked out of him before, he does now. 30 seconds remaining. Backdrop, and the champ is down.
Go get him.
The pitch. He's going to go for the pin.
Go get him.
Now, this is it.
No.
This is it.
He's got to pin him.
15
get him.
Seconds.
Get him.
If
get
he slaps, he's got him.
He's got him in the big
guy. 10 seconds.
10 seconds. 9, 8, 7.
You he's checking. He's going to take him down. He's got him. He's got him. He's going to take it. The trooper took Zbyszko down.
Well, was it in time?
Yes. Yes. Oh, my God. The trooper. The impossible dream. The heavyweight champion. What?
Wait.
What?
Wait a minute.
Are they saying the time ran out?
Time had elapsed.
Oh, my Lord. Oh, my word.
But Larry Zbyszko was beaten today.
Well,
I'd
love nothing more than agree with you. But we said from the beginning, Ralph, it was going to be television time. I thought we were very meticulous about letting everybody know not only what the stipulations of the match were, but how much time had elapsed. Oh, my word. Oh, my word. Well, Zbyszko may walk out of here this afternoon with that belt tucked under his arm, but he must know that he and the trooper are not finished.
Nevertheless, the trooper is back, and he's going to be back in fine form. In today's first match, he'll be facing Kent Carlson. Let's go now down to the ring for the announcements.
This next wrestling matchup is scheduled for a one-fall bout. Introducing currently in the ring from Springfield, Illinois, weighing in at 235 pounds, he is Kent Carlson. And his opponent making his way into the ring area,
Economic.
He
this guy, and why shouldn't they? A positive role model for the youth, Lee.
Yep.
Say no to drugs. He's an all-natural trainer, and I've had a chance to visit with him in the locker room prior to the match, and I mean, this is a guy that is really genuine and really just a tremendous talent, tremendous man.
Yep. Good to see him, too. As we've said before, he looks like he gets dressed in a boat.
Oh,
he does look like Superman.
Well,
good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Championship Wrestling on ESPN, your Total Sports Network. Lee Marshall and ringside Ralph Spangers bringing you all the action, beginning with the Trooper and Ken Carlson. Trooper on your right, Carlson on the left. And the big man with the tights, the long left arm of the law, as Ralph has nicknamed him, undefeated in the AWA thus far, Ralph.
Yeah, the Trooper is... Oh! And I... You know what? We saw this guy last week.
Yeah.
And he's back. I don't know who he is or what he's doing.
Sure, I don't know who he is either.
Wow. Well, you know, Lee, it's a sporting event. People come out, they dress. We talked about that last week.
Yeah, you know how people dress when they go to an NFL game.
Oh, forget that guy. I mean, the Trooper's doing business in the ring.
Ooh, slap Kent Carlson. I mean, if you think, I don't mean to really discount the effort of Kent Carlson, but come on, man.
No.
You got to know that you're not going to do anything to the Trooper by trying to hit him with a couple of flying boxes. I mean, bigger and more experienced men have tried that, and it didn't work for them either. There's that long left arm, Ralph.
The long left arm of the law, as the Trooper would say.
Oh. Running elbow, and down goes Carlson.
Tremendous athlete, but involved in professional football, played for Atlanta and Tampa Bay, and he has translated that into being a top-notch wrestling contender. And, you know, he's got that solid work ethic. This guy works hard to get where he is.
Right into the midsection by the Trooper. That left hand dug deep into the midsection of Carlson, taking him over for the back suplex. He got him. Oh, he got him off.
Nothing to it if you're the Trooper.
Those of you that follow the career of the Trooper knows that he likes to use a move called the big pinch. If he can get Carlson into a weakened position, he'll go after Carlson from the back, put those big meaty hands into the trapezius muscles of Carlson, and literally take him out. It's a form of a sleeper. In the meantime, Carlson digging into Trooper's eyes, referee trying to break him up.
Whoa. You know, and if you're Ken Carlson, you got to do something.
Oh, yeah.
You got to do something. I mean, at this point, Trooper's manhandling you. Just get in there. Get a shot in any way you can, and that's what he's trying to do.
Absolutely.
Oh!
Booed into the midsection. Yeah, Carlson has got to know that whatever he's been doing so far just is not working.
Not effective at all. He tried it with a rake of the eyes, but now Trooper's got it going his way again. Whoa!
What a move by the Trooper. It looked like it was going to be a backdrop.
Man.
And we want to re-emphasize something that you mentioned earlier, Ralph. When you look at this athlete, you're looking at a natural athlete. That means no steroids, no drugs, no chemicals, no substances. And now he's talking, do a little hand talking, little hand jive. And that means it's time for the big pin.
There it is. The big pinch from the Trooper. It's only a matter of seconds before the blood supply is cut off, and he'll notch a victory. You don't get out of this one.
Now, the referee, this is where the referee really earns his money, because Carlson is in a position where he could be injured if Trooper keeps that hold on too long.
And that's
okay, good job by the referee. Ring the bell now, Trooper. Get off.
This guy is unbelievable. Yet to have his shoulders bent in the AWA. And a man who, whoa, watch out. Future talent. I'm not forgetting. He's here. He's arrived.
Oh, yeah. He has arrived. He has arrived.
Check it out. There he is saying to the crowd, I'm going to do the pinch. I'm going to do the pinch. Check me out.
Now, Carlson. He's just trying to get to his feet. Trooper already knows he's got him compromised.
Oh, wow. Look at him dig in, too.
I mean, that's what it must be like when you get bitten by a shark.
I didn't think it was possible, but Trooper, you're looking bigger. You're looking stronger. You've got your game face on. I mean, we're counting down to the Super Bowl of professional wrestling. It's coming up here not too long from now, and you're looking as good as I've ever seen you.
Well, Thanks, Eric. And the reason I am looking bigger and stronger, it's quite simple. I am bigger and stronger.
No doubt about it.
And before we get into the professional wrestling end of it, a lot of times we forget what's really important, and that's these kids right here, each and every one of them. And we want those kids to remember school's going to be out pretty soon. Hey, and you stay out of trouble, okay? Huh? You got it? You do that for the trooper, right? You stay out of trouble. You look out for yourself, I'll look out for you, okay? Now, one other thing. Larry Zbyszko, you better look out for your behind too, friend, because I'm not through with you yet. As a matter of fact, I'm young, vibrant, I've got a long career. We're just getting started, buddy. This thing's just getting started right now, and we're gonna keep going and keep going and keep going until I have the gold around my waist, and I am the heavyweight champion of the world. Thank you, Eric.
All right. Thank you, Trooper. I think he got his message across not only to Larry Zbyszko, but to all these kids that came out here to see him. Stick around. We're coming back your way right after this break.
Messen, your ticket to more than 300 live events each year.
From the rocky coast of Maine to the shores of Cape Cod Bay, Belmont Springs water tested every day. It's been trusted in New England for 100 years and more. Belmont Springs, natural and pure. It's pure New England.
Belmont Springs.
Pure New England.
Belmont Springs.
Belmont Springs water, at your store or delivered free to your door.
Saturday, NASCAR goes Hollywood in a special behind-the-scenes look at the making of Days of Thunder.
Welcome back. Wrestling fans, certainly two of the men that are chasing Larry Zbyszko around the world, hoping for an opportunity to get their hands on the heavyweight championship of the world, are the Trooper and the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. Now, we got a look at the Trooper in today's first match. Right now, let's take a look at the end of a match featuring the Russian Nightmare and the Timekeeper, Mike George, in a Team Challenge Series main event.
Oh, did he ever. You know, you ask about 98% of the guys that got into the ring. They're carrying scars from him. And the same can be said for Mike George and Nikita Koloff. Could very well be the very next victim of the Timekeeper, Mike George.
Uh-oh.
Reverse chin lock. DeRusha says it's not a choke. It's clean, and it is.
Koloff in big trouble, Bryce. Perhaps the first time I've seen him. I mean, he is on the ropes.
He is. Knee into the back by Mike George, followed by another knee.
I don't know if he'll get him in 3 minutes, but he's sure working on it.
Well, he better believe it. The Rusha checking, making sure it's not a choke in it. It is not. I think Mike's trying to get him into position, looking for maybe either a neck breaker.
Nikita.
What a good counter by Nikita. Comes out with an arm ringer and a couple of right hands. And George with a rake in the eyes of Nikita Koloff.
George,
and here comes big Mike George.
And he went right back to work. Went right back to work. He didn't let Nikita recover.
Once again, Mike George working over Nikita Koloff. Into the corner goes Nikita. And down goes Nikita. Now that is a choke.
Oh. You can hear referee Gary DeRusha screaming in the background. Stay off the choke.
Once again, the reverse chin lock was a choke. DeRusha told him to break it up. And Nikita, he's in a lot of trouble here.
And as you would say, Lee, don't adjust the color on your sets.
No, that's his color.
That's
he
right.
is bright red.
Oh.
Nikita's got it now. Nikita's got a hold of that blonde head on Mike George, ramming it into the turnbuckle. just ready to go.
And no matter what language you count, there's an awful lot of times into the corner.
Referee telling the key to keep that hand open. By Nikita.
One, two.
With no reversal by George, into the corner goes Nikita. Right hand by Mike George.
Very physical match.
And again, Nikita takes the corner. George goes shoulder first, and Nikita gets out of the way. And there's the Russian circle. That's it.
That'll do it.
Fans, they know all about Mike George. And I think Nikita Koloff found out about Mike George as well. George heading for higher ground. DeRusha trying to call Nikita off. Nikita Koloff, the winner.
There you have it, fans. That match featuring Nikita Koloff and the timekeeper, Mike George, courtesy of All Star Wrestling. Earlier on in the program, we saw the long left arm of the law, the trooper, in action against the heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Zbyszko. That match ending in a television time limit. But Larry Zbyszko, you must admit, you are facing double jeopardy with both the trooper and Koloff looking for a shot at your title.
You know, Bischoff, it's lucky for the trooper that he did run out of time, because I have just about had it with the tactics that this man tried to use, long arm of the law. What a joke.
Well, look,
you want to talk about justice? You want to talk about, you know, if being the heavyweight champion of the world, Trooper, and Nikita Koloff, if that's what's going to make you happy, if that's what your life's all about, then why don't they get down to it? Why don't they wrestle each other and the best man wins himself a one-way ticket to Larryland?
Or maybe that's just an easy way for you to eliminate one half of the competition for your title.
I think it sounds very fair. I think that's the way it should be. You know, a little bit of like when men were men and women kept their mouths shut. If this is what makes you happy, then come and get it. But do it the right way. Climb the steps one at a time. Prove yourself like I did when I retired San Martino. Show me you're what you're made of, like I showed Bockwinkel when I ended his career. You want to get happy? This is joy, brother. Right here, this belt. This is your ex-wife and her boyfriend getting in a car wreck and dying. This is happiness, and it belongs to the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world.
Electrifying.
Championship Wrestling here on ESPN. And for you fans that may have just joined us, our main event today features the World Tag Team Champion Destruction Crew putting their titles on the line against DJ Peterson and Rick McCord. Right now, I want to talk about the Team Challenge Series. Fans, from the very beginning, the Team Challenge Series committee promised us excitement. They promised us surprises, and oh, how they have delivered. Not only in the matches, but in the standings themselves. I think fans around the world shocked and surprised at the current leader. For more details, let's go now to Lee Marshall with a Team Challenge Series update.
Well, there's no doubt about it. The Texas Hangmen have a rather unique style all their own when it comes to professional wrestling. Well, so do the Lumberjacks. Last week in the Team Challenge Series main event, Hangman Killer faced Yukon John in what was destined to be a brawl. Each man had their tag team partner in their respective corner, but after an exchange of words and a chase around the ring and into the locker room, the referee told both men to go back to their locker rooms so that the match could continue. Now, Yukon John seemed to have the match well under control when Hangman Psycho entered the ring and tried tried to choke the giant lumberjack with his hangman's noose. Well, of course, Flapjack Norton was watching closely, and as soon as he burst into the ring, the Texas hangman ran away, leaving Yukon and Flapjack in the ring with the hangman's nooses and 1 point because of a disqualification. The point gives the Blitzers a 3-point lead over the Snipers and a big 5-point lead over the Legend. I'm Lee Marshall.
Welcome back to Championship Wrestling. Fans, I'm sure that when Jim Evans woke up this morning, he could have thought of 15 things he'd rather do than face Hangman Psycho. But that's the way of the world in professional wrestling. You dance with the one they gave you. And in today's next match, we're looking at Hangman Psycho and young Jim Evans. Let's go down to the ring for the announcements.
The following matchup is scheduled for one fall. Introducing from Longview, Texas, weighing in at 216 pounds, he is Jim Evans. And his opponent, making his way to the ring area, hails from Waco, Texas. Weighing in at 266 pounds, he is the Texas Hangman, Psycho.
Well, Lee, I see a pair of them again.
Yeah, I know.
It's late now. They both come out. Which is which? Who is who? And they pulled the old switcheroo more than once.
Psycho, killer. Well, it's Psycho that's supposed to be in with Jim Evans this afternoon.
Well, let's keep an eye on it now. Psycho is in the ring, and he's got the red boot on his left side.
Okay. Now, that leads even more people to believe that these guys are twins. I mean, it's one thing to wear the same size shirt as somebody. That's not unusual.
But no, not at all.
I mean, the same size boot? I mean, they obviously went out, they got two pairs of wrestling boots made. But you take a red one on this foot, I'll take a red one on this foot, we'll put the black ones over here. It's really difficult to tell who is who, but
well,
the man signed to be Jim Evans is Psycho.
There's that hangman's noose. They have made use of it before. I remember not too long ago they pulled Jake Millman halfway across the building with that thing.
Yeah, they sure did. The pride of Waco, Texas. No offense, Waco, but that's what they claim to be. Well, let's just presume, Ralph. Let's presume that is Hangman Psycho.
Killer also has the vest on. He's made no move to take that off. So right now it's easy or easier. At least this is Psycho or Psycho today that is representing.
We want to remind wrestling fans, coming up a tremendous main event right here on ESPN. Well, championship committee and President Joe Blanchard said, okay, let's go for it. I'm talking about the team chief, DJ Peterson and Rick McCord. They're going to get a chance to be tag team champions of the world this afternoon.
And after their impressive re-debut, at least the first time we saw them, which was last week here on Championship Wrestling, right on ESPN, they really looked impressive, and they've got a shot at the belt. This guy here, Hangman Psycho, his partner, Hangman Killer, were livid prior to this match saying, hey, we've been in line, we've done the work, why don't we get the shot?
Well, they've got a point.
They do have a point.
And they're also undefeated.
That's correct.
They have not lost a tag team match in the AWA. They have not had their shoulders hit. Now, that's Killer. Let's presume that's Killer going to work on Evans.
Outside the ring area, and they have worked together in tandem so often. Why can't Killer just go sit in a locker room somewhere? I mean, who's standing in Evans' corner?
Nobody that I can see.
No. Only Gary DeRuscia to officiate things here, and you can't watch everything.
Well, anyway, that match is coming up this afternoon on the ESPN main event, the Destruction Crew, as they face the team of DJ Peterson and Rick McCord. Texas Hangman, they're a little bit upset as we
see. Oh!
Look at the Lumberjacks. Jack Norton and Yukon John, they thought that maybe they should be in line for a tag team shot. Regardless, it's going to be one heck of a match, and that's coming up for you later on this afternoon.
All eyes will be on to see if the Destruction Crew can keep the belts. They have not yet lost it since they got it in that six-man tag team.
Yep. Heads-up move by Evans. Oh, a boot to the midsection by Psycho.
Oh.
Spinning neckbreaker by Psycho. That could take him out.
Nice move.
That could break his neck.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, too.
Well, you know what? We've seen these guys, and whenever they wrestle, they don't like to go the early pin.
Oh, no, no.
They want you to remember who you were in the ring with.
And I would think that because they were, as they say, snubbed by Joe Blanchard and the championship committee, I think that Psycho may go out of his way to make an example out of young Mr. Evans. DDT. Oh, my Lord. He planted him with the top of his head right into the middle of the mat.
You heard Killer say, not yet. We got to do one more, and that was it. Holy cow.
You can count that. Oh, I'm really concerned about Evans.
And the eyes of Longview, Texas are upon young Jim Evans as he lies prone.
Gary DeRuscia, the referee, checking on Evans. I mean, Psycho. He planted him like one of those post-hole drillers, and boom!
An ice auger, if you will.
Yeah, an ice auger.
Great North.
Now, have another look at this. Watch the top of Evans' head. Ah!
Dude. Look at him. Look at his eyes spinning. You can see that from here.
Gary DeRuscia going to do the 1, 2, 3, and he can count, like I said, he can count to 100.
There's a way.
Welcome back to Championship Wrestling right here on the Total Sports Network. Wrestling fans, our next match features one half of the biggest tag team, the most powerful tag team in professional wrestling today, the Lumberjacks. And we're talking about specifically Flapjack Norton. Let's get down to the ring for the announcements.
The following event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing from Sturgeon Bay, Wisconsin, weighing in at 229 pounds, he is Tom Bennett. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent entering the ring area hails from the Great North Woods, weighing in at 350 pounds. He is the Lumberjack, Scott Norton. Accompanied Scott is his tag team partner, UConn John Nord.
Yes, you heard correctly. 350 pounds, Flapjack Norton.
Eats a lot of flapjacks. You know, we heard last week on ESPN that the reason he got that nickname was he ate a lot of flapjacks up in the Northwoods before anybody else got there. He put away 200.
He broke the record. He broke the record by five, as I understand it. The loggers were up there, and, you know, they like to eat flapjacks, pancakes.
Yeah.
And Scott Norton beat the rest of them there by about 20 minutes. They walked in. There he was, knife and fork in hand. And he had literally set a record for eating flapjacks. Well, the Lumberjacks gave the big man a nickname, Flapjack Norton.
And look at these two guys. Talk about flapping each other.
You've seen football players do that when they slap shoulder pads together and knock helmets together.
But this is skin on skin.
Well, you're talking about guys that are a little bit tougher than most.
Yeah.
Scott Norton, Flapjack Norton, UConn John Nord, the Lumberjacks. A couple of guys that think that they should be entitled to a championship match. Later on today, you will see a tag team championship match. The Destruction Crew defends against former Central States champions DJ Peterson and Rick McCord. This will be for the AWA Tag Team Championship of the World.
Whoa!
Tom Bennett in there with 350 pounds of flapjacks.
Unbelievable. Former arm lifting champion of the world right there.
Yep. Super heavyweight arm wrestling champion. Beat them all.
Showing his stuff. Yeah.
He said it's also technique. Not only is it just the brute strength, but there's technique involved in that as well.
You're darn right there is. And nobody did it better.
Ooh, look at this. Look at you talk about strength and technique.
To put him just about anywhere he wants to.
Ceremony involved in that. Sit here, have a seat here, son. Let me show you how we do it up in the Yukon.
Springfield, or Sturgeon Bay, Wisconsin, rather, never saw anything like that.
With Bennett hitting him right into the chest with those thundering forearms, having no effect on Flapjack Norton. Norton likes it. So go ahead. Give me your best shot.
You got Johnny.
Give me your
some
best
harder
shot.
Than
that. Oh, look at this. One arm. Oh, and down goes Bennett.
Holy cow.
With one arm, Ralph.
That's that arm.
Reverse knife edge. Another one by Big Flapjack. Into the turnbuckle. Threw him across the ring like a big old gray sack of grain.
I mean, it's like there's no gravity in the ring.
Oh! took a power body slam and turned it into an art form. I mean, that was perfection.
And Ken Carlson is, I'll tell you what.
Look at these guys. These guys are... what do you say? Not both oars in the water?
I think
with a full deck. A
couple of bricks short of a full load.
Yeah, their elevator doesn't go to the top floor.
No film in the camera.
They like it. They're just knocking the hell out of each other, and they like it.
It is unbelievable.
If we get a replay of this, you're going to see a picture-perfect power slam. I mean, wrestling fans have seen power slams before, but watch this.
And watch
you
him
won't
use
see
the
it
weight.
Any better.
Look at this.
Turn. Oh,
smash.
Poetry.
Thank you, Lee. Flapjack Norton looking bigger and stronger than ever. We're going to talk about him in just a minute. But joining me now, the World Tag Team Champion Destruction Crew, who in just a little bit are going to be involved in today's main event. They're going to be stepping into the ring with the former Central States Champions, DJ Peterson, Rick McCord, and I'd like to direct this to Mean Mike Enos. You can't be taking these guys too lightly. They've worked together quite a bit.
You're looking at...
Come on, Mike, I'll handle this one. You know... Bischoff, you come out here and you start talking about Peterson and McCord like they actually have a chance against the Destruction Crew. You're talking about Central State Champions? You know, what is that, some other kind of regional deal? We're the world champions, and we're here to stay world champions. There's no way some ex-former Central State Champions are going to take the Destruction Crew down.
All right, that's your opinion. You're welcome to it. But I want to talk about the Lumberjacks, the biggest tag team in professional wrestling today. Flapjack Norton, Big Yukon John Nord. I know they're looking for a piece of the crew.
Them two smelly
Hold on,
guys.
Mike, I'll handle this one. You know, Yukon, you know, Norton, I've seen you work.
And I know you're big, and I know you're strong. Probably the biggest team we've ever faced.
The one guy says he throws
Hold
logs
on,
Mike,
or
I'll
something.
Handle this one.
But we didn't get to be world champions by beating up punks. We beat up some very, very good wrestlers. You know, you guys come out here and you start hitting each other. You see, that isn't how it works. You're supposed to be a team. You gotta work in sync, like the Destruction Crew. We're a team. We got eyes in the back of our head. We can see what's going on wherever we are. UConn, Norton, there's no way that you guys are going to take these titles away from the Destruction Crew. And if you think you are, keep wishing, boys. We're going to send you back up north in the woods where you belong.
The wrestling equivalent of the Grand Tetons. We're talking about the Lumberjacks, the biggest tag team in professional wrestling today, and one of the most popular. We're getting cards and letters from kids all over the world that watch this team on ESPN. In fact, guys, we got some cards from Lumberjack camps in Norway, in Sweden, in Finland, all kinds of support all over the world for the Lumberjacks. But just before the break, Flapjack Norton, we heard the Destruction Crew. They had a lot to say about you and your partner.
You see, Destruction Crew, I've been in the ring with you more times. I know you better than any man in professional wrestling. I've had a number of partners. I've been in the ring with you by myself. Well, take a look at this, because when we come at you, baby, it's straight down, it's fast, and it's going to be hard.
Destruction Crew, all I've heard you do is a lot of complaining, and all I've seen you do is a lot of running. Well, I tell you something, Destruction Crew, I wouldn't want to sign on the dotted line with this man and me either. But I tell you what, when it finally does happen, and when we get our hands on ya, it's gonna be all over. Larry Zbysko, you're the heavyweight champion of the world. And a Lumberjack's never been a heavyweight champion of the world. Let me tell you, Zbysko, we're after you too, because we don't care, and we ain't scared.
All right. Plenty of action here. Right now, let's get down to the action at the ring.
You know, they say time.
Welcome back to Championship Wrestling here on ESPN. Wrestling fans, when you think of the World Tag Team Champion Destruction Crew, what comes to mind? Is it destruction? Is it bodily injury? Is it career-ending injuries? Well, indeed, Wahoo McDaniels, Brad Ringens, and a host of other opponents would probably tell you so. But in today's main event, DJ Peterson, a man that's looking forward to stepping into the ring once more with the Destruction Crew, is standing by. He and his partner, Rick McCord, will face the crew for the World Tag Team Championship belts. Let's go now to the ring for the announcement, today's main event.
The following is an ESPN main event. It is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the AWA World Tag Team Championship title. Introducing first, accompanied by Christopher Love, are the AWA World Tag Team Champions. From Chicago, Illinois, at a combined weight of 524 pounds, they are Wayne the Train Bloom, Mean Mike Venus, the Destruction Crew.
This is your main event on ESPN, and I gotta tell you something, Ralphie. There are a lot of tag teams that are not real happy about it. I mean, the Destruction Crew, the heavyweight champions of the world, the tag team champions. You can see their belt. But the challengers this afternoon, DJ Peterson and Rick McCord, I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you what, we saw them last week in a pretty impressive debut here.
Yeah.
And right away, they're getting shots, but Texas Hangman upset. They wanted this match. Other tag teams wanted this match as well, not the least of which the Lumberjacks.
The Lumberjacks are furious. They wanted a shot at the Destruction Crew.
But it's the crew right away, and they're hot and heavy and furious and getting it on.
There's Rick McCord, partner of DJ Peterson. And make no mistake about it, these young men did not get the opportunity to be the tag team champions of the world by winning some sort of jingle contest. They are the former Central States tag team champions. Now the Destruction Crew having their way with DJ Peterson. Mean Mike Enos picks him up for the slam, puts him in the middle of the ring, says, I think I got a special delivery for you right here.
Oh, right against the ring post. And I'll tell you what, the Destruction Crew has successfully defended their title every time. I want to ask you this. Looks like they've gained some weight.
Oh,
in,
yeah.
In the person of Christopher Love, who's hanging by ringside. I mean, what's Love doing in the cruise?
Oh, did you see that?
Mighty well together. McCord and Peterson, and you know, it is no accident they're here today. We've talked about the speculation that there's other teams very upset, but these two guys belong here based on their merits and based on AWA Joe Blanchard, President Joe Blanchard's signing, saying, okay, go ahead, guys, do it.
Well, they were impressive. We saw them before. They look great. And there's the guy you were talking about, too, Ralph. Christopher Love. He first came into the AWA, bringing in a man that he originally managed, for those of you that are wrestling trivia buffs. He was the original manager of the Super Brat, Tully Blanchard, and he brought Blanchard back into the AWA. Then all of a sudden, he shows up with Lord Humongous.
Oh, yeah.
How did you describe him? 6'8", 10,000 pounds?
9'4", 9,385 pounds. Big guy. And now he's here with the crew now.
Now look at this. Who is this guy? Who is this guy?
Oh, I've seen him earlier. We've seen him earlier.
Oh, okay.
Very strangely garbed, I don't know what he is doing here, but
I'm not going to make anything out of it that it might not be. I mean,
no.
People come to wrestling matches a lot of the times like they come to NFL games.
That's right.
I mean, see the way people are dressed coming there. Jeez Louise, Mike Enos whipping DJ. Look out! Look out!
DJ quickly out of the way.
Arm drag by Peterson. Tag made. Here comes young Rick McCord.
Oh!
Right onto the left arm of Mean Mike Enos, and Chris Love does not like that.
And there's no way that he should like that, because right now the crew really needs to turn it around. There's Enos getting back to crew. Wow, McCord was waiting.
What a great move by Rick McCord. Tremendous move.
And we saw Rick McCord very quick last week. Again, we see him this week. The former Central States champions, these two, going to work here on the crew. The belt's on the line.
They have been a team, I would wager to say, as long as the Destruction Crew. They did split up for a little while. Here comes DJ right onto the left arm of Wayne the Train Bloom. Referee saying, watch yourself, watch yourself. Ooh, look at that grapevine. Grapevine the arm into a bar, into a, almost a scissors on top of the throat as well. DJ Peterson's got him wrapped up like a Christmas package, Ralph.
And the referee looking out, as you mentioned, is Gary DeRuscia, one of the very best in the business. Gets the call for this title match, and wow, what a great pace. I'm wondering which team can outlast the other. Very quick pace for this match.
Incredibly big pace for big guys. You know, when you see big guys wrestle, Ralph, a lot of times you'll see them slow up just because they can't keep up that rigorous pace. But you got some monster guys in there. The Destruction Crew, DJ Peterson. I mean, these are big, big men, and they are just going at it like they're doing 40-yard dashes.
Tried to tag one of the cameramen up there in the corner. I mean, he is very disoriented right now. DJ Peterson really going to work.
Referee admonishing Christopher Love, and now both Peterson and McCord in. Double teaming Wayne the Train Bloom, double arm drag. And now McCord working on the left arm.
Well, you mentioned four big men in the ring. The smallest is McCord, and he goes 232.
Yeah, it's tough to be 232 pounds, 6 foot two, and have someone call you tiny.
Oh.
That'll give you an idea just how big these men are. And strong, when you talk about strong, Wayne Bloom for 3 years, winning consecutively. Look at this! Backdrop by McCord.
Great move by McCord.
I do want to finish my thought on Wayne Bloom, 3 years running, powerlifting champion of the world.
And he's going to need all his strength today.
I'll tell you, if McCord twists that arm one more time, Bloom's not going to be able to lift a cup of coffee, let alone weight.
Oh,
frantic
pace, and McCord and Peterson really setting tempo, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely, and now McCord into a front chancery, still holding onto the arm, takes Bloom into the corner, reversal by Wade, reversal by McCord, what a heads-up move by Rick McCord into the monkey flip, and right onto the AWA logo, Fanny first goes the train.
Train is in big time trouble right now, Lee Marshall.
Back into the standing arm bar. Mike Enos making a little motion into the middle of the ring. And here comes DJ.
Wayne Bloom complaining about the tag, but referee Gary DeRuscia was turned the other way.
Tough job, DeRuscia's got.
Oh, unbelievable, especially with four men this pumped up.
Oh, yeah, because it's all on the line here. Destruction Crew, they want to hold on to those AWA Tag Team Championship belts. Christopher Love, he's already talking about everywhere he's taken the Destruction Crew to defend. They're going to go to Tokyo, Japan very, very soon to defend there.
Well, they got
to take him to the Soviet Union as well.
Oh.
But they got to get by Peterson and McCord this afternoon on ESPN.
I was going to say, they need belts to go on those road trips.
Tag mate, here comes Meet Mike Enos. Hold by DJ. What a quick move.
Incredible.
And Christopher Love, he's coming undone over this.
Tremendous move by DJ Peterson. Mm-hmm. And you mentioned, I mean, Chris Love is just beside himself.
Look at this, setting him up for the monkey flip. He launched him. DJ launched Mike Enos, and here comes Peterson. Oh!
Teeth clenched just watching that.
That could be the one miscalculation that could mean the match for the Destruction Crew. DJ Peterson, right into the small of the back. The big ham hock arm, away the Train Bloom. Reverse suplex, and down goes Peterson. He's rocked now.
Oh, he is really rocked. He was dishing it out on one end, and now it's Wayne the Train Bloom coming back after that big miss in the corner. Look at the train. I mean, these two guys, the Destruction Crew, don't just have the belts. They have earned them, and they have kept them. They have defended the title well.
Oh, yeah.
And you got to beat these two guys, and the fighting is round.
You lose again.
The Destruction Crew has got a real attitude. Double elbow by the crew.
They are so great.
Because they had Christopher Love. This is so great. This is so great.
Yeah.
One, two, kick out.
When they talk about the belts, they say they're my belts. They're our belts. I mean, we know that not to be true, but that's the attitude. Power slam by Mean Mike. One, two. Out by DJ.
But that is an attitude, Lee, that has kept them on their waists.
That's right.
So you can't question success. Especially success when it comes to Mike Enos and Wayne Bloom.
Got to agree with you there, huh? Absolutely right. Laying the weight down. Really putting the weight down. Reverse chin lock. Referee checked. It is not a choke. He said it's clean.
DJ coming back. Rallying the troops. Rallying
the
support.
He's trying. He's trying.
Very clear. Which side? The fans here.
He's on his feet. Peterson is up. Section. Another elbow. Forearm by Mike Enos. Into the ropes goes Peterson.
Head
flip. He's got him now.
One, two. Wayne Bloom came in. Wayne Bloom came in. Chris Love distracted DeRusha on the apron. And now look
he's
at this.
He's got
DJ's
him.
DJ's got him again.
Two.
Two. Oh, my.
New champions of the world this afternoon.
Oh.
Enos did the right thing. Said, get me out of here.
Holy cow.
Wayne the Crane hooks him up, takes him vertical, got him, suplex, could be it.
Beautiful suplex by Wayne Bloom, going for the casual
two,
cover.
Three, no, only the two count. You're right, a little bit cavalier on
yeah,
that cover, Ralph.
He surely was, you know, I mean, he had DJ Peterson finally at the point he wanted him. Now continuing to soften him up, and in comes Enos.
That's a couple of big body slams DJ Peterson has taken. And now here comes Mean Mike Enos, headbutt, ouch!
Oh.
Into the back of the head by Mean Mike. Got DJ by the hair, picking him up for the slam. Boom,
oh,
right in the middle of the ring. And now scrubs his boot across the forehead of DJ Peterson.
Enos looking pretty confident now. Goes to the second rope. Got a big smile on his face. Oh!
Did a little too much posturing. A little too much showboating up there on that second rope. Gave Peterson enough of an opportunity to clear his head and tossing him out a little bit.
And look at Peterson trying to get to the tag. He got there before Enos did.
Here comes McCord. Rick McCord's in. He's just looking for someone to hit. And he's got Wayne the Train Bloom.
Off of the ropes.
Back drop. He planted him like a tree. Big right hand into the forehead of Mike Enos. Body slamming. Down goes Bloom.
All four men in the ring. Now Peterson outside of it.
Going for the stretch. Locking him on the abdominal stretch.
But look at DJ.
Peterson's got to get out of the ring, otherwise the referee is not going to even check on the possibility of a submission. Here comes Bloom.
From off the top, DeRusha had to deal with DJ Peterson.
And Enos has got a hold of a cord, the two.
Oh!
Oh, did you see the lady at ringside shaking her head going, oh. Got in DeRusha's way as well. Let's have another look at it.
Absolutely. You see in the background, DeRusha's head is turned. You see in the foreground, the damage done. Wayne Bloom sneaks out of the ring, and Mike Enos goes for the cover just in time for DeRusha to count it down. The crew keeps the belts.
Hey, they are the tag team champions of the world. Let's check in now with Eric Bischoff.
Wrestling fans, for weeks now, experts all over the country have been naming the tag team of DJ Peterson and Rick McCord as a tag team that most likely stands a chance to take the titles away from the Destruction Crew. But unfortunately, guys, it wasn't today.
This is not an interview. This is a promise. This is a promise going out to all you people. This is a promise going out to Wayne Bloom and Mike Enos. I don't care when it is. One of these days, boys, the time is going to come where you're not going to be able to do that kind of stuff. Somebody's going to catch you. A referee, two referees. I don't give a damn, make it no DQ. But I want the World Tag Team Championships. And I got my buddy back from Kansas City, Missouri. We used to be Central States Tag Team Champions. And I tell you what, baby, you took all you could take right there. We will get the World Tag Team title sooner or later.
All right. We felt the gold before around our waist, and it's going to happen again, we promise you.
All right, you heard from a very determined Rick McCord and DJ Peterson.
Promise.
Stay with us. We're coming right back. We'll be right back.
We're here at an athletic shoe store to see people's reactions.
That's great.